Warren Buffett's net worth is around $90 billion today. But did you know that it was only $1 billion when he was 60 years old? In this video, you are going to learn how to turn $500 into tens of thousands of dollars with long-term investing. Stay tuned! What's going on, guys? Welcome to a new video about why you should reinvest your profits. Let me start by saying that this video isn't going to make you rich overnight, it shows why you should reinvest your profits in the long run. With this method, you can turn your $500 into tens of thousands of dollars, but it will take a long time. Let's say you invest $500 for S&P 500 for the average 8% return on investment. In 5 years, it would be worth $734.66. In 20 years, it would already be over $2,300. And in 60 years, over $50,000. So how does this happen? The reason for this is the compound interest. Let me show you what it means. All these examples that I am about to show are not made up stories that I want you to believe. I am using the past 40 years of the S&P 500 for the average annual return on investment. But before we get into compound interest, let's first show an example of simple interest, which means that you are not reinvesting your profits. Let's use a $500 investment and 8% annual interest rate for our examples. The first year your return on investment will be $500 times 0.08 equals $40. Now you don't reinvest your profits, you would rather buy 8 Starbucks coffees. So the second year your return on investment will be the same, $500 times 0.08 equals $40. And now you spend it again. The third year comes and your profits will be the same, $500 times 0.08 equals $40. When you are not reinvesting your profits will stay the same forever. But because of inflation, your money loses value all the time, so the $40 won't really be worth $40 in the long run. Only way you can make more money without reinvesting your profits is by investing more. So that is the reason why you should reinvest your profits. When you reinvest your profits, it has a snowball effect, which is called compound interest. Let's show an example of compound interest using the same numbers as in the previous example, the principal being $500 and the annual interest rate of 8%. So again, your first year profits will be $500 times 0.08 equals $40. This time though, you have found Graham Stephan's YouTube channel, so instead of wasting your profits on Starbucks, you decide to drink 20-cent iced coffee and reinvest the $40. So now, in the second year, your profits will be $540 times 0.08 equals $43.2. Now you reinvest that again and your third year profits will be $583.2 times 0.08 equals $46.6. Now you probably think that why would you want to reinvest your profits if it only makes you a couple dollars more a year? Well, because in the long run it makes a huge difference. 50 years later with simple interest, your profits would be the same, $40 a year. But with compound interest, they are already over $1,700 a year. So in 50 years, your annual profits are over 43 times more than they would be without reinvesting your profits. The time and the annual interest rate have a huge impact on your profits. You can check the website in the description for a compound interest calculator, so you can test out how it affects your profits. For example, if you used 15% annual interest rate instead of 8%, the $500 would be worth over $500,000 instead of $23,000. If you invest for 10 years, your profits would be little over $1,000, but if you invest for 50 years, they would be almost $23,500. That is why you should start investing as soon as possible, your future self will thank you later. So it is simple to turn your $500 into tens of thousands in the long run. You just have to invest your money as early as you can and for as long as you can, and reinvest your profits. So why isn't everybody rich then? Most people lack the discipline or just want to enjoy their money. When I try to explain to my family why I won't spend $5 on a coffee or why I haven't bought new shirts for 5 years, they think there is something wrong with me. But that $20 shirt is really worth a lot more than $20, in 30 years it would be worth $200. Ask yourself a question, would you rather take $1 now or $10 in 30 years? Let me know in the comments. With that small amount, most of you probably would rather take $1 now than wait for 30 years to get that $10. But what about $10,000 now or $100,000 later? That is how I personally think about every product I want to purchase. In 30 years with 8% annual interest rate, every product would be worth 10 times more. Is it really worth buying those Starbucks coffees for $50? or a new iPhone for $10,000. I'm not saying that you should never buy anything you want, just think about the value it provides now versus in the future. Of course you can spend some money every now and then, but imagine paying even $2 a day for a coffee. It is $730 a year and $7,300 in 30 years. Does it really bring so much more value compared to making your own coffee for 20 cents? I'd rather save that money, invest it in the stock market, and then reinvest the profits that I make, slowly making the snowball so big that it would smash that like button into pieces. When you constantly reinvest your profits and also save more money to invest every year, the snowball really starts to grow into a huge avalanche. Let's just use that coffee for example again. If you managed to save that $700 a year and your first investment was $500, you would have over $90,000 in 30 years, and almost half a million in 50 years. And that is only with the coffee. Let's say you start to save money on clothes, shoes, drinks, lunches, and cars. Investing $2,000 a year is over $1.2 million in 50 years. So there you go, you are now a millionaire with just saving and investing $2,000 a year and reinvesting your profits. It is a slow and boring way to become a millionaire, but it sure works. Personally, seeing the profits grow more and more every year really makes it addicting, and I want to save more and more so I can invest more every year. Some people don't want to invest their money because they don't really know much about investing and they have heard that you could lose everything. While it is true that sometimes the market crashes, in the long run, the S&P 500 has averaged that 8% annual interest rate used in the examples. Great thing about index funds is that you don't really have to know much about investing to invest in the S&P 500 index fund. If you want to know more about how to start investing, you can check the top right corner for a step-by-step guide on how to make your first investment. Shortly put, you just need a brokerage account, some money to invest, and to choose which index fund you want to start investing in. This takes less than a couple hours and you can automate it for the rest of your life. You could use brokerages like Vanguard, Fidelity Investments, and Ally Invest for example. So that is how you turn your $500 into tens of thousands of dollars and the reason why you should reinvest your profits. They will be worth tens of times more than the profits with simple interest would be in the long run. The most important thing is to start investing as soon as possible and to start saving money to invest more every year. This has a snowball effect that makes a huge difference compared to simple interest. Invest $2,000 a year and become a millionaire in 48 years. The more you save and invest, the quicker you become a millionaire. If you find this video helpful, smash that like button and share this with your friends, it would really help my channel to grow. Subscribe if you're interested in personal finance, investing and book summaries. Next week's video will be a book summary for the book Way of the Wolf by Jordan Belfort. You can also check my other social medias on the screen. My name is Finest Finance, have a great day, and I hope to see you in the future videos.